So what he does, وَيَبْسُطُ, he basically should point his fingers, كَفِّهِ الْيُسْرَى, his left finger, his left hand, عَلَى فَقِذِهِ وَرُكْبَتِهِ الْيُسْرَى, on his left, and he should open it. He should slightly open it, widen it out. Why is the left specifically mentioned for? His only left one, because his right, he's going to use it for his tashahud. So the ruling for the other hand is going to be different. So this hand shouldn't be like this. The person's fingers should be open a bit when they're on their thighs. Should open. Then what does he do? وَلَا يَجُوزُ أَنْ يَجْلِسَ مُتَعَمِّدًا عَلَى يَدِهِ وَخُصُوصًا الْيُسْرَى وَلَا يَجُوزُ, it is not permissible, and he should not أَنْ يَجْلِسَ مُتَعَمِّدًا, that he sits deliberately, عَلَى يَدِهِ, on his hand, وَخُصُوصًا الْيُسْرَى, on his left. وَلَا يَجُوزُ, it is not permissible, and يَجْلِسَ, for the person to sit, مُعْتَمِدًا, relying, عَلَى يَدِهِ, on his hand, وَخُصُوصًا الْيُسْرَى. So the person should put his hand on the side and just lean on his hand, and not put it towards his, on his thigh. Just lie on the side like that. Whilst doing the tashahud. تحريك الأصبع, the moving of the finger. تحريك الأصبع, the person to move their finger. ويقبض أصابع كفه اليمنى كلها, he grabs all his right fingers, all of them, he grabs them, all of them like that. When he grabs it, ويضع إبهامه على إصبعه الوسطى, and he places his thumb on his middle finger. So he does that, and he does it like that. So his right finger is holding it like that, and he does it like this. نعم الوسطى. وتارة يحلق بهما حلقة. And sometimes what the person does is, at times he makes a hole inside it. You see, like that, onto the middle finger. So there's a حلقة, there's a little hole in there. ويشير بأصبعه السبابة إلى القبلة, and this finger, which is the سبابة, faces towards the قبلة. ويرمي ببصره إليها, and he looks at it. He throws his eye onto it. Meaning he looks at his finger. ويحركها, and he moves it. يدعو بها, that he moves it, making du'a with it, من أول التشهد إلى آخره. From the moving, when does it start? From the beginning. When does it finish? To the beginning. All of it. Just do it like that all day. That's it. That's what the Sheikh said. ولا يشير بأصبع يده اليسرى, and he doesn't point. He doesn't point with his left finger. So you can't do التشهد with your left finger. You have to do it with your. ويفعل هذا كله في كل تشهد, and he does that all in what? All his tashahud, all of them, the first and the last, the middle tashahud and the last tashahud, he does the same. He does this all his. وَسِيغَةُ التَّشَهُدِ, and the form of the tashahud. وَالدُّعَاءِ بَعْدَهُ, and the dua after it. He's going to tell us now how to do it. وَالتَّشَهُدُ وَاجِبٌ, the tashahud is wajib. وَإِذَا نَسِيَهُ, if he forgets it, سَجَدَ السَّجْدَتَيْ سَهُ, if a person forgets that sajda, that tashahud, the middle one, he has to come with two sujood after the salah. ويقرأه سرا, and he recites it very low. You don't التحيات لله, you don't say it loudly, you're very low, you say it loud. وصيغته, and the form to recite it is like this, التحيات لله والصلوات والطيبات السلام على النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد وأشهد أن محمد العبد ورسوله. The Sheikh, what did he do? He changed the word أشهد على السلام على السلام عليك. السلام, نعم. The Sheikh, he changed it. He changed it. التحيات لله والصلوات والطيبات السلام عليك أيها النبي عليك. The Sheikh said the Prophet died, and he's over now. He's gone, and that used to refer to him when he was alive. So they used to say, Alayka, on you, O Messenger of Allah. Where is he now? He's gone. So because he died, ba'da mawti, after his death, alayhi salatu salam, the person should say in the tashahud, ala nabi, on the Prophet. Ah. It can't be classified as the. لأن الحكم يدور مع علة وجودا وعدما. because the reasoning revolves around the existence of that thing. If the thing moves out of the place, then the ruling changes with it. When the Prophet was alive, some scholars take the stance that no. No.
No doubt.
But remember,
there is now.
Yeah, there is.
So what's the strongest opinion?
Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Aisha and Abdullah ibn Zubayr and Ibn Abbas, all of them took the view that you say Ali Nabi. We'll go into the tarjih and the explanation of it when we come to the bigger version of the book. The strongest view is that the person should say Ali Nabi. The Shaykh says after that, وَيُصَلِّي بَعْدَهُ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. After he's done the tashahud and he said the tahiyyat, what does he do? He sends salutation on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He sends what? Salutation on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. That's what the person says. So he does the tashahud, and then after that he sends salutation on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. وَإِنْ شِئْتَ and if you want, al-ikhtisara, to summarize, if you just want a very short, you can say Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad wa barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallayta wa barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidu majid. So instead of making the salli and the barakah two different, you can emerge them into one and say it like that. All of these are narrations that the Shaykh is not mentioning now, because of the fact that the book is a summarized version. And that's what we're doing as well. We're just explaining it, no, it's too much. Just mentioning what is on the text. ثُمَّ يَتَخَيَّرُ فِي هَذَا التَّشَهُدِ. Then the person, after he's read the tashahud, and he sends the salutation of the Messenger, what is he entitled to choose? It's his choice. After the tashahud and everything, what type of dua he wants. مِنَ الدُّعَى الْوَارِدِ. But that dua has to be submitted by narrations. أَعْجَبَهُ إِلَيْهِ. That fascinates him. فَيَدْعُ اللَّهَ بِهِ. He can ask Allah for it. الرَّقْعَةُ الثَّالِثَةِ. The third rak'ah and the fourth rak'ah. ثُمَّ يُكَبِّرُ وُجُوبًا. Then Allahu Akbar, he says. So he's done the tashahud. He's finished it. He says Allahu Akbar. وَالسُّنَّةُ أَن يُكَبِّرُ وَهُوَ جَالِسٌ. The sunnah is that, in that tashahud, that he does the takbir whilst he's sitting down, not once he stands up. وَيَرْفَعُ يَدَيْهِ أَحْيَانًا. Sometimes he lifts his hands up, sometimes. ثُمَّ يَنْهَضُ. Then he makes his way up to the third rak'ah. وَهُوَ الرُّكْنُ. And it's a pillar. كَالَّتِي بَعْدَهَا. Like the one after it. The fourth is also a rak'ah. The person comes with the standing up, and the way he goes up is a rukn, it's a pillar in every rak'ah. وَكَذَلِكَ يَفْعَلُ. And that he does إِذَا أَرَادَ الْقِيَامِ إِلَى الرَّكْعَةِ الرَّابِعَةِ. And the fourth rak'ah, that's the way he does it when he wants to get up. وَلَكِنَّهُ بَتْ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَنْهَضَ يَسْتَوِي قَاعِدًا عَلَى رِجْلِهِ يُسْرًا. But on the fourth rak'ah, the third rak'ah, when he does it and he wants to go towards the fourth rak'ah, what does he do? He sits for a little bit before he gets up. Just like he did the second one, remember? He sat for a little bit on his left leg, and his body straight, and his back straight, until he becomes what? His body straight. ثُمَّ after يَقُومُ مُعْتَمِدًا عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. Then he gets up with him depending and holding onto his hands, put like that. كَمَا فَعَلَ فِي قِيَامِهِ إِلَى الرَّكْعَةِ الثَّانِيَةِ. The way we explain when he stood up for the second rak'ah, with his hands, he's clenched his fist. ثم after that, he stands for the fourth rak'ah, the third and the fourth, both of them, what does he recite? Surah Al-Fatiha, and it's wajib. Every rak'ah, he has to read what? Surah Al-Fatiha. وَيُضِيفُ إِلَيْهَا آيَةٌ أَكْثَرَ أَحْيَانًا. Or he can increase a verse or even more. So a verse is the minimum he can read after Surah Al-Fatiha. You read a verse? No, we can't, no. Because then what about ayah to Dain? Ya iladina amanu idha tadayyantum bidayni ila ajl. Last long ayah, which is a safha. In Surah Al-Baqarah, the longest ayah. Yeah. It's one ayah, right? The person recites that. It's a whole page. So it's a ayah or more than that, he recites. Al-Qunutu lin-nazilatu wa mahalluhu. The salah is finished. We finished the salah, but we just have one more thing left. Just one more thing left. We have the tashahud, the last tashahud left. How are we going to do that? But before that, the last rak'ah, what normally happens after the ruku'? Dua. Dua al-qunut. A lot of the people, the last rak'ah, they use it. So Sheikh is trying to mention if that's going to happen in the salah. Al-qunutu, the supplication. The salatu al-qunut, which is a special supplication. Wa yusannu, and it's a sunnah. Lahu, for him, an yaqnuta, for him to do the special dua. للمسلمين, for the Muslims, لنازلة نزلت بهم, when a problem occurs to the Muslims. An issue happens to the Muslims, a calamity strikes them, it is a sunnah, highly recommended sunnah, that the person makes dua for the believers. It's sunnah, he should. Not forget his brothers around the world. ومحله, and the place for it is what? Where do you do the qunut? إذا قال بعد الركوع ربنا ولك الحمد. After he stands up from the ruku', what did he say? ربنا ولك الحمد. The Malikiya, they believe that the qunut is before the ruku'. Before the ruku'. This is the view of the Malikiya. When they read the Surah Fatiha, وَلَضَّالِينَ آمِنْ for themselves. They make the dua, then they go to the ruku', and then from the ruku', they go back to the dhunub. That's what they believe. It's sunnah for them, according to the hadith that they've come across. But the Sheikh is saying the place for it, the correct place for it is where? After the ruku'. وَلَيْسَ لَهُ دُعَاءُ الرَّاتِبُ, and there's no specific dua that is appointed for it. There isn't. وَإِنَّمَا يَدْعُ فِيهِ, he makes the qunut بِمَا يَتَنَاسَبُ مَعَ النَّازِلَ. He makes the dua in accordance to what the problem of the Muslimin is. If the Jews and the enemies of Allah has invaded the Muslims and are massacring the Muslims, he can specify his dua against the Jews. Wherever they are, may Allah destroy them where they're doing. So his dua is not a specific. It's whatever this case is. Or if the Muslims are suffering in terms of there's no rain that came down and they want rain, or rain came and it killed all people, it killed the people. You can ask Allah to uplift the Muslims' heart. Or a time where the Muslims are dying because of the poverty that has stricken them. Whatever it is, he makes a dua for that. To that time. وَيَرْفَعُ يَدَيْهِ, he lifts his hands up. في هذا الدعاء, he lifts his hands up where? In this dua. People say the qunut, you don't lift your hands up. Where's the dilit? There's no dilit for that. You lift your hands up when you're doing the qunut. You lift your hands up. وَيَجْهَرُ بِهِ, so the person, the qunut, when he's making the dua, he lifts his hands up. وَيَجْهَرُ بِهِ, the recitation of the dua, the imam reads it loudly. إِذَا كَانَ إِمَامًا, if he's an imam. وَيُؤَمِّنُ عَلَيْهِ مَنْ خَلْفَهُ, and those behind him, they say, Ameen, Ameen. They say the Ameen. فَإِذَا فَرَغَ, when he finishes, كَبَّرَ وَسَجَدَ. After he finishes the dua, what does he do? He goes to the sujood. He goes to what? He says, Allahu Akbar, and he goes to the sujood. He has to say Allahu Akbar. Because remember, he's between the sujood and the ruku'. So he's in between the sujood and the ruku'. He hasn't said the Allahu Akbar to enter the ruku' sujood. Remember, he just said the dua and then he made the dua after it. So that Allahu Akbar has to come from him. He said Allahu Akbar. قنوت الوتر ومحل وصيغته. قنوت الوتر. The qunut for the witr. We mentioned the qunut for the salah, right? Then qunut al-nazila, the problem that strikes the Muslims. What about the qunut for the what? The witr. What about that one? And where is its place and where is its what? Its form. وَأَمَّا الْقُنُوتُ فِي الْوِتْرِ, as for the qunut in the witr, فَيُشْرَعُ أَحْيَانًا, one should do it sometimes. Not every witr should there be qunut. Tarawih, you see, every witr there is a dua. And if you don't do, the people get angry. The people get angry. وَمَحَلُّهُ, and the place for it is قَبْلَ الرُّكُوعِ, before the ruku'. وَمَحَلُّهُ, and it's the place for it is قَبْلَ الرُّكُوعِ, before the ruku'. خِلَافًا لِقُنُوتِ النَّازِلَةِ, different to the qunut of the nazila. So the one for the witr, where do you do it?
Before the ruku'.
Before the ruku'. The imam, he finishes, he makes the dua. Then he goes to the ruku' for the witr one. ويدعو, and this has a specific dua. This is the one that has the اللهم اهدنا في من هديت. This one he says, اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت وبارك لي فيما أعطيت أم وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقني أم وقنا, and he finishes that dua. So there is a dua for that one. مأثورة, the person has to recite that dua. وهذا الدعاء, and this supplication, من تعليم رسول الله, is that which the Prophet taught us. فلا يزاد, no one is allowed to increase onto that. إلا الصلاة عليه فتجوز. Except what? To tell salutation on the messenger. This long fancy qunut dua that people make in salat tarawih, all of that, لا دليل عليه. The person should just stick with this. They should only stick with this what? And send salutation on who? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Adding anything onto that? No. Shouldn't increase anything onto that. Except the salutation of the messenger is permissible. لِثُبُوتِهَا, because it's narrated to us from the companions they did it. لِثُبُوتِهَا عَنِ الصَّحَابَةِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنُهُ. ثُمَّ, after that, he does the ruku'. وَيَسْجُدُ And he does his two sujood as we have informed it before. The final tashahud. The final at-tashahud. We're going to take the final point, inshallah, which is the tashahud and how to do the salams, and we finish the salah book, inshallah, بإذن الله الكريم. At-tashahud al-akhir. The final tashahud. The final tashahud. What does he do? ثُمَّ يَقْعَدُ لِلْتَشَهُدِ الْأَخِيرِ The person sits for the final tashahud. وَكِلَاهُمَا wajib. Both of the tashahud are wajib. The first and the, both of them are wajib. وَيَصْنَعُ فِيهِ He does in the last tashahud. مَا صَنَعَ فِي التَّشَهُدِ الْأَوَّلِ That which he done in the first tashahud. He does it in the last tashahud. The second. إِلَّا except. Except. أَنَّهُ يَجْلِسُ فِيهِ مُتَوَرِّكًا He sits in it what? Mutawarrik. What does mutawarrik mean? The final sitting of this one is that his left hip resting on the ground and his foot is like it was for the first one. The final tashahud this now is his hip bum is on the floor, his leg is like this, and the fingers have to face towards the qibla as much as he can make awesome. It happen. No other method. That's the difference between the first and the second. Now, which ishkal leaves? A person. Abu Bakr came to the salah, he came late. He came late. He saw the people in the tashahud. If they sat on their left hip, what would he realize? And also, he would know if they're on their first tashahud. Because of the differences between the two. So all of these are things that the person has to make sure that he does. He sits mutawarrikan. Yufdi biwarakihi al-yusra ila al-ardi. ويخرج قدمه من ناحية واحد ويجعل اليسرى تحت ساقه اليمنى. It's as I told you, his left hips resting on the ground, and with his foot on the right side, he places his left foot beneath his right shin. So his leg goes close, tucks it in, and it stands. It stands. وينصب قدمه اليمنى. And as I said, his right foot it should be placed in an upright position. ويجوز فراشها أحيانا. And it is allowed to lay it down flat sometimes without the fingers being towards the Qibla. But sometimes it's allowed. We're going to mention these issues in another time, inshallah. وَيُلْقِمُ كَفَّهُ الْيُسْرَى وَرُكْبَتَهُ يَعْتَمِدُ عَلَيْهَا He should lean heavily on his left knee. He should put towards his body, tilt it towards what? His left knee. With his palm supporting himself in that manner. يَعْتَمِدُ عَلَيْهَا وجوب الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والتعوذ من الأربعين. You have to send salutation on the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم and seek refuge from Allah. Mandatory. Four things. You have to. In every tashahud, the last tashahud, you have to do this. Wajib. If you leave it, you're a sinner. You're leaving with a sin. What is it? ويجب it is mandatory. في هذا التشهد that tashahud to send salutation on the Messenger. It is wajib. وقد ذكرنا we have mentioned how that person sends a salutation on the Messenger in the first tashahud. When we mentioned in the form, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, and then we mentioned it. وَأَنْ يَسْتَعِيدَ And that he seeks refuge from Allah min arba'in four things. And he has to say, it's wajib. He says, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adhabi jahannam. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from the punishment of the hellfire. Mandatory. Also, وَمِنْ عَذَابِ الْقَبْرِ And from the punishment of the grave. وَمِنْ فِتْنَةِ الْمَحْيَا وَالْمَمَاتِ The fitna of living and the fitna of dying. In this world is a fitna. And the dying is a fitna. وَمِنْ شَرِّ And the fourth which is وَمِنْ شَرِّ فِتْنَةِ الْمَسِيحِ الدَّجَّالِ And the shar and the evil of the fitna of Masih al-Dajjal. Every person has to do this in his dua, in his tashahud. If one does not do it, in the last rak'ah in his salah, he is sin. He's left with a sin. He's left that which a messenger. الدُّعَاء قَبْلَ الصَّلَاةِ الدُّعَاء The dua قَبْلَ الصَّلَاةِ The الدُّعَاء قَبْلَ السَّلَامِ Sorry. الدُّعَاء قَبْلَ السَّلَامِ The dua that is made before the taslim, before the person, he leaves the salutation. ثُمَّ يَدْعُو He makes dua. لِنَفْسِهِ For himself. بِمَا بَدَى لَهُ That which becomes apparent for him. بِمَا بَدَى What becomes apparent for him. مِمَّا ثَبَتَ That which is affirmed. فِي الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ إِنَّ كِتَابَ النَّسُنَّةِ وَهُوَ كَثِيرٌ طَيِّبٌ And it's a lot and it's good. فَإِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ عِنْدَهُ شَيْءٌ مِنْهُ If he doesn't have any dua with him, da'a bima tayassara lahu, he will make dua in what is easy for him. Mimma yanfa'uhu fi deenihi aw dunya, that which will benefit him in this world and the hereafter. At-taslimu anwa'uh. the salutation, the salams, the person makes in the salah. How should one make it? In what form? In what form? Thumma, after that, he's made his dua, he's made his tashahud, he's stuck out his finger was pointing his finger, and now he wants to do the taslim. The finger goes down as soon as he does his first taslim. His finger goes down. Thumma, yes, thumma, after that, yusallim an yameen, he makes his taslim from the right first. وَهُوَ الرُّكْنُونَ It's a pillar. حَتَّى until يُرَى بَيَاضُ خَدِّهِ الْأَيْمَنِ Until his cheek will be seen from the other side. They can see the Prophet will do it until the whiteness of his cheek will be seen. Clearly, عليه الصلاة والسلام, like that. It will be seen from the companions, like that. So it's nothing like, or like this. The person has to turn fully. That he looks at his shoulder fully, turns his whole head around. So he does it properly. Salam. And he makes the other taslim. Hatta yura bayada khaddihi al-aymani. Wa an yasarihi, and also the left. Hatta yura khadda al-aysar. The Prophet, until his cheek would be seen, alayhi salatu salam. Walau fi salati al-janazati. Even if the salah is what? It's a janazah prayer, which has no ruku'u or sujood. Na'am, alayhi salatu salam. So the person has to do it. Salam and salam. Sahih? He does it. وَيَرْفَعُ الْإِمَامُ صَوْتَهُ بِالسَّلَامِ The imam has to raise his voice with the salam. السلام عليكم. السلام عليكم. He has to say it loudly. إِلَّا فِي صَلَاةِ الْجَنَازَةِ Except صَلَاةُ الْجَنَازَةِ وَهُوَ عَلَى وُجُوهٍ And the janazah is of forms. الأول. The way to do the salutation is of forms. These are the types. The person, what does he do? He says, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته on his right side. عن يمينه on his right side. And his right side, he said, this is the way to do it. He says, As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And then, his left, what does he say? As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. He doesn't add wa barakatuh to it. That's the first way. The second one is, he does the same without saying barakatuh. He says, As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. That's the second one. The third, which is, As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. On his right. And then on his left, he says, As-salamu alaykum. This. That's the third. The fourth is, he makes taslim wahid tilqa'uchi. He just does one taslim. He says, As-salamu alaykum. That's it. He says that. يَمِيلُ بِهِ إِلَىٰ يَمِينِهِ قَلِيلًا But when he is doing that one, he turns towards his right slightly. Not all fully. He just does it slightly. That is on his right, and he doesn't do his left. And what does that show you? The salah ends there, so the person who is praying behind the imam, when the imam says, As-salamu alaykum, the first one, don't wait for the second one, stand up, wait when he does the first one. You with me? The first salams is the first one. The sheikh said, Akhil Muslim, my Muslim brother. The sheikh finished the salah book. So he says, oh Muslim brother of mine, هَذَا مَا تَيَسَّرَ لِي مِنْ تَلْخِيصِ صِفَ صَلَاةِ النَّبِيِّ This was what became easy for me and I was able to do in regards to the abridged version of the book صِفَ صَلَاةِ النَّبِيِّ The Prophet's prayer described مُحَاوِلًا I tried لِذَلِكَ in that أَنْ أُقَرِّبَهَا إِلَيْكَ I tried my best to bring it close to you as much as I could حَتَّى تَكُونَ وَاضِحًا لَدَيْكَ So it could become very clear مَاثِلَةٌ فِي ذِهْنِكَ And that it's become present and firm in your mind وَكَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهَا بِعَيْنِكَ And as though you can see it, as though you can see the Prophet pray with your eyes. I've tried to do that. فَإِنْ أَنْتَ صَلَّيْتَ نَحْوَ مَا وَصَفْتُ And he said, if you pray according to the way I described for you, مِنْ صَلَاتِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَصَفْتُ لَكَ مِنْ صَلَاتِهِ from his prayer, فَإِنِّي أَرْجُو مِنَ اللَّهِ He said, I hope from Allah by that. تَعَالَى high he is. أَنْ يَتَقَبَّلَهَا مِنْكَ That Allah accept your salah from you. If you pray the way I described for you, I hope that Allah will accept your salah from you. لِأَنَّكَ بِذَلِكَ بِكْ Why? What reason? Is it because he wrote the book and that he has superiority and you should follow him? لا لِأَنَّكَ بِذَلِكَ because of that تَكُونُ قَدْ حَقَقْتَ فِعْلًا قَوْلَ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ Because that means you have fulfilled as it was needed from you the speech of the messenger صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِ أُصَلِّي Pray the way you see me pray You fulfill that You've done it ثُمَّ عَلَيْكَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ And after that what is needed from you أَلَّا تَنْسَى That you do not forget الْإِهْتِمَام The importance باستحضار القلب that you make sure you bring your heart with خشوع والخشوع فيها فإنه هو الغاية الكبرى because the biggest intent of the salah is the خشوع min wuquf al-abdi, it is that you stand in front of Allah as a servant, bayna yadayillahi ta'ala, in front of Allah, wa biqadri ma tatahaqqaqu, wa biqadri ma tahaqqaqu min fi nafsika min hadha alladhi wasaftu laka min al-khushu', and in accordance to what becomes a present in you in the khushu' of the salah, wal ihtida'i bi salati, and follow his prayer, yakunu laka. So in accordance to your khushu' and in accordance to your following of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is in accordance to what your reward will become, al-muthmirat al-marjuwa, that you can hope from Allah, allati asharaha, that ashara ilayha, that which has been pointed out, Rabbuna, our Lord pointed out, tabarak wa ta'ala, in his speech, inna salata, that the salah, tanha anil fahshai wal munkar, the salah will prohibit a person from evil and zina. Now here, the salah will only stop you from all of that is when you're praying accordingly. And then you also come with the istihbarul qalb, and the heart is done for Allah's sake. Wa khitaman, as a conclusion and finally. As'alullah, I ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, an yataqabbalaha minna salatana. I ask Allah that he accept from us our prayer. Wa sa'ira a'malina, and the remaining of our actions, other actions. Wa yudakhira lana thawabaha, and that Allah seals, he keeps for us. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, ila yawmin alqah, until the day we meet him, yawma the day, la yanfa'u malun wala banun, the day where wealth will not benefit you, wala banun, and children will not benefit you, illa except man atallaha, anyone who comes to Allah, biqalbin salim, a person who comes to Allah with a pure heart, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. And we finish the book over there. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.